You are a partner in the award-winning website development company, Cyplex. And you mentioned to me before, and you said I could tell everybody your company does about $5 million in annual revenues. So it's a big company, and you have how many employees now?
We have about 44 employees.
Okay, so obvious success story here. I'm going to start with something sort of negative. Tell me about your biggest mistake. First of all, you started this company when you were 17 years old?
Right. I started it in high school when I was 17. It was one of those things. I grew up as a computer nerd. Everyone came to me to fix their local computer. I was kind of that, you know, that kid that went around the neighborhood. And then I went to a friend who was a designer. I went to another friend who was a developer. And, you know, I said, let's kick this thing off and, you know, I'll run the business and you guys build the sites. And that's kind of how it took off.
And then at some point you decide, this is what I'm going to do for a living, for real life.
Yeah, so I kind of on the same parental path. I went to college to make my parents happy. I mean, I had this company early on, so I didn't feel like I had to, but at least, you know, they moved across the world for my brother and I, so I did that. But after college is when I decided to take the company on its own. I moved to LA from the East Coast, and that's really when it became a real company instead of just being a side gig. And that's when, you know, I found a partner here. I started to make my first hire. And over the last probably about 6 years is when we grew from, I think we started off 6 years ago, like 40,000 a year in revenue to 5 million last year.
And when you made your first big mistake, how old were you? And how did you screw up? What did you do wrong?
So that's a good question. I never had, you know, real corporate jobs. So I never knew how to manage or how to be a good boss. My first biggest mistake was honestly with my first hire, and then my second hire and so forth. I didn't fix that mistake till I had about 10 employees, and that was literally micromanaging.
What was wrong with the first hire?
I thought the
employee appropriate?
He was perfect, but I thought I could do better than all of them, right?
So you're always up in this guy's grill.
Right, I'm always like correcting him, questioning him, and then, you know, now that fast forward 5-6 years later, I look back and even look at myself, nobody wants to be in a position where somebody's literally babysitting, watching them, and making, you know, like corrections every step of the way. I think one of the biggest lessons that I've learned from this is learn to accept that 80% is good enough. Like, do not be a perfectionist, especially when you're delegating a task to somebody else and they're doing it. Even if they make mistakes, that's how a business scales. If you sit there and you literally just correct them and micromanage them, they're going to hate working for you, and you're not going to be able to scale a company. You're not going to be able to control that many people at the same time.
How many of you have employees right now? Not that many. How many of you are horrible micromanagers? Show of hands. Oh, wow, everybody's in a self-confessional mode. There's at least half a dozen of you.
It was one of the hardest things to give up.
So if you take anything away from this, the 80% rule, you really have to learn to compromise and say, okay, that'll work for me.
Don't be a perfectionist.
Yes.
So kind of on the same path of delegating and not micromanaging, one of the biggest things I've learned was in order to scale a business, you have to hire people. You have to give up what you do and give it up to somebody else. And a fellow entrepreneur once told me that, look, Ilya, if you want to make $1 million, that's about $500 an hour, right? So learn to delegate everything that costs less than $500 an hour to accomplish. And that's the only way, and I know it doesn't sound realistic in the current sense, and it's still not at all realistic in all senses, even for me, but that's a good kind of, you know, threshold to look at that, hey, should I file my own paperwork? Should I run and FedEx this package? Or should I sell this deal myself? Or can I give up a percentage of that revenue or that cut or create an expense from it so that I can actually generate more revenue? And at the end, what this allows you to do is actually work on the business rather than in the business. And I think that's one of the biggest walkaways that I've had is, you know, if I could rewind 6 years and just look at today where I am, I would have probably made hires faster and delegated more earlier on and kind of let go of that control.
Questions from the audience? Just raise your hands.
That's a great question. It actually tends to work itself out. I know it's hard to see right now, but the second you empower people to be autonomous and you accept 80% is good enough, they themselves are going to strive for perfection. It's just, it's the idea of you not being there and babysitting them and just getting on their nerves, because then they feel like they're working to make you happy rather than the client, right? So if you back away from that, then you're going to see that perfection still come from the right people in your company as long as you have them.
I think we're out of time. Thank you, sir.